Okay, let's do that again. Let's pick a different pivot point, though.
All right, well, in this case, let's choose the pivot point now to be up here where T2x.
Okay.
In that case, we're still going to be solving for the sum of torques being equal to zero. And we also will still be looking at an orientation axis such that counterclockwise is the positive direction of rotation.
Perfect. Okay. All right. Well, let's go through each of those again.
All right. We still have the same four forces taking place in this scenario, so we can still solve for four torques.
All right. Well, look at the torque for T1. Now it's a distance of 1 meter away. We're going to do the R times F perpendicular one. This time, though, to get the component that's perpendicular, we want to do this component. So that's going to be T1 sine of 60 instead of cos of 60 as last time.
So we're a meter away.
Right.
And we have T1 sine 60.
Right.
Boom.
Not only that, so we've got now sine instead of cos. We've got a different distance because we moved the pivot point. And this is supposed to be a clockwise rotation, so this is going to be a negative torque.
Right. If we take this as our pivot, this T1 would actually rotate it this way,
right,
giving us a negative value for the torque.
So everything depends on where we put the pivot point. Okay, well, for that example, T2, it's right on the pivot point, so again, that's a torque of zero.
Right. We have our value that's equal to zero in either of the two techniques that we use.
Okay. The torque due to the weight now, we're going to use the second method. So we're going to draw our line right over top of the force, and we're going to connect that back to the pivot point. So now we're a distance of half a meter away from the pivot point. So we're going to write 0.5 meters times W. And that's going to try to rotate the sine about the pivot point in the counterclockwise sense. So that's, again, a positive torque. All right, finally, then there's the normal force. And we got to use the second method again. So our line of action acts right over top of this. That's a distance of 0.4 meters away from the pivot point. So we write 0.4 meters times the full value of the normal force, no component. That's trying to get it to rotate counterclockwise. So again, a positive torque.
And yet again, what we need to do is to take the sum of these entire series of equations there, set it equal to zero, and that'll allow us to solve for any unknown values of the force that we have at that point. Science!